Welcome, friends. Now today, we're in this Thursday of the fourth week of the year. I want you to listen to this gospel reading. It's a well-known one. Jesus is sending out the 12. But pay close attention to what they're required to do and what they're forbidden to do. I'll talk about that in the homily today. Please stand. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the Lord be with you. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. You came to call the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Have mercy.
You plead for us at the right hand of the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Grant us, Lord our God, that we may honor you with all our mind and love everyone in truth of heart. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Brothers and sisters, you have not approached that which could be touched, and a blazing fire in gloomy darkness, and storm and a trumpet blast, and a voice speaking words such that those who heard begged that no message be further addressed to them. Indeed, so fearful was the spectacle that Moses said, "I am terrified and trembling." No, you have approached Mount Zion and the city of the living God, the heavenly Jerusalem, the countless angels in festal gathering, and the assembly of the firstborn enrolled in heaven, and God, the judge of all, and the spirits of the just made perfect, and Jesus, the mediator of a new covenant, and the sprinkled blood that speaks more eloquently than that of Abel. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The responsorial psalm is, O God, we ponder your mercy within your temple. O God, we ponder your mercy within your temple. Great is the Lord and holy to be praised in the city of our God. In his holy mountain, fairest of heights, is the joy of all the earth. O God, we ponder your mercy within your temple. Mount Zion, the recesses of the north, the city of the great king. God is with her castles. Renowned is he as a stronghold. O God, we ponder your mercy within your temple. As we have heard, so have we seen in the city of the Lord of hosts, in the city of our God. God makes it firm forever. O God, we ponder your mercy within your temple. As your name, O God, so also your praise reaches to the ends of the earth. Of justice, your right hand is full. O God, we ponder your mercy within your temple.
Alleluia, alleluia. The kingdom of God is at hand. Repent and believe in the gospel. The Lord be with you.
And with
with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. Jesus summoned the 12 and began to send them out two by two and gave them authority over unclean spirits. He instructed them to take nothing for the journey but a walking stick. No food, no sack, no money in their belts. They were, however, to wear sandals, but not a second tunic. He said to them, "Wherever you enter a house, stay there until you leave from there. Whatever place does not welcome you or listen to you, leave there and shake the dust off your feet in testimony against them." So they went off, and they preached repentance. The 12 drove out many demons, and they anointed with oil many who were sick, and they cured them. The Gospel of the Lord. Again, you know, for all of you at church, I had just forgotten to tip the camera back down after I sang the Salve, so hi. I know I'm short, but it's not that short. This gospel passage from Mark, it's well known. This notion that Jesus, who's been doing this great ministry, teaching, preaching, driving out demons, curing the sick, Jesus is now expanding that work by empowering his disciples, the 12, to go out. He is empowering them and equipping them to do what he has been doing. But there's a sense here of what they are to trust. It's not in stuff. They don't need to bring extra food. They don't need to bring a sack to put anything in. They don't have anything to carry. They don't need to put money in their belts. They're going to rely on God's providence. They're going to trust. They're going to trust that God will take care of their needs and that as they're doing God's work, God will provide. That's pretty amazing. Now, there's a couple of practical things. They get sandals. It's kind of hard to be walking if your feet are sore. They get a walking stick. Now, that's not just for balance. That's if you're out there walking, you also have that to take care of predators. So an interesting combination of what you should use that's very, very practical, and then this sense of relying on God. But there's something in this. They're going to do this work that speaks very, very eloquently to me today in light of the pandemic. Jesus does not send them out alone. He sends them out two by two. He sends them out in pairs. And there's a very rich insight both into our human life, our spiritual life, and the way we face our challenges. You know, when we're alone, when we're isolated, when we're cut off, we are so vulnerable. We know that practically. We know that spiritually. And we know that in a special way in the face of all of the social distancing that has truly isolated a substantial number of people and made them extremely vulnerable. And the fact is, social distancing has made all of us more vulnerable in some senses because we have been limited from our connections, our opportunity just to run up and give somebody a hug, let alone be able to have plenty of cups of coffee face to face. A lot of people, in order to take certain precautions, have become very isolated. Jesus sent them out in pairs to do his work. And so today, as we recognize that as we carry out God's work for our lives, we recognize our need to be connected. And that has two distinct elements that I think are our takeaway today. The first is this. Folks, is there anybody who's laid on our heart, a tug, if you will, that we need to reach out to? Might be picking up the phone. It might be just sending an email, sending a letter. But something we do, because there's this tug on our heart that says, I recognize I got a brother, I got a sister, I got a neighbor, I got a friend, I got a family member. I need to reach out. Hey, how you doing? You want to talk? We need each other. And we can offer support and encouragement. We can offer hope, especially when we know the people in our lives who are really struggling. And we might be that somebody who's walking with somebody because they're having a tough day. Who are the people that we can reach out to?
That's one side of the equation. But remember, it goes both ways. How are we doing? Are we hanging in there? A lot of people are feeling ground down right now. That could be any one of us. Jesus recognizes that we also need help. We don't just give it, we receive it. And so, all of us, and I'm looking at all of you at home, do we need to reach out to someone and say, hey, you got a minute? I could really use somebody to talk to. That sometimes we're the one in need of the hope, help, strength, support. He sent them out two by two, and they did great things when they worked together with his grace. And when we call upon God for help, we face whatever our challenge, our obstacle, with a hope, because we are united. And God works through people, and God puts people in our life to help us and for us to help them. Today, in light of this gospel passage, who can we reach out to? And in light of this gospel passage, to whom do we need to go for the help we need? Friends, today, God's at work. God's going to continue to walk with us. May we trust in Jesus as we go out into the world with good people around us, as we walk in this journey from this life to the next. God bless you all. We pray this day for the church, for Pope Francis, for our bishops, that they will lead and guide us on this journey to follow and serve Jesus. We pray to the Lord. We pray for all those who do missionary work in and throughout the world, proclaiming the good news of Christ, who trust in God's providence as they proclaim the good news. We pray to the Lord. We pray for those who are struggling in their faith right now with doubt, fear, anger, for those who are distracted by many, many things going on in our world, that through our efforts, they may come to know Jesus. We pray to the Lord. We pray for all who are sick, for all the people we know and love who could use a prayer for healing today. We pray to the Lord. For an end to the pandemic. But frankly, friends, as we face the pandemic, we call upon God's help, and we reach out to the good people around us. We pray to the Lord. The Mass intention today is for Norm Rankela. We pray to the Lord. For all of you at home, for the prayers that you offer in the comment line. They're beautiful. They're from the heart. It's an honor to offer them up here on your behalf today. For all of us, for the prayers we now offer in silence. We pray to the Lord. Gracious and loving God, look kindly upon us. Hear the prayers we offer now, spoken and silent. We make them all in the name of Jesus, our Lord.
Amen.
O God, we earnestly ask you to bless our diocese with many priests, brothers, sisters, and deacons who will love you with their whole mind and heart and gladly spend their entire lives serving your church and making you known and loved. Bless our families, bless our children, bless those needed for your work. Mary, Queen of the Clergy, pray for us. Pray for our priests, religious, and deacons. Obtain for us many more. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. For your goodness we have this bread to offer, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness, we have this wine to offer. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink. Pray, sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, our loving Father. O Lord, we bring to your altar these offerings of our service. Be pleased to receive them, we pray, and transform them into the sacrament of our redemption. Through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Father most holy, through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your Word through whom you made all things, whom you sent as our Savior and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin. Fulfilling your will and gaining for you a holy people, he stretched out his hands as he endured his passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so with the angels and all the saints, we declare your glory, as with one voice we acclaim, Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, he broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. And once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, James, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your love and mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. And have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
through him, with him, in him. O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin, and safe from all distress and useless worry, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. The kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God, behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you in my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Nourished by these redeeming gifts, we pray, O Lord, that through this help to eternal salvation, true faith may ever increase. Through Christ our Lord. Just a couple of simple announcements. I want to just remind everybody, blame the polar vortex that's coming, but I note that there's some pretty severe cold weather that we're going to be dealing with through the weekend. I want everybody to be safe and practical. Now more than ever, I'm grateful that we have the ability to live stream a Mass so that if people really aren't, it's not smart to get out, you have that option. And just know that our prayers always are joined to those of you who are watching us online. I want to just continue to invite folks, get ready for Lent. This Sunday we'll be rolling out more of the opportunities that will be available, and a Lenten mailing was sent out this week to all registered parishioners in my cluster of parishes. So for all of you who get those mailings, okay, from any of the five churches, just note that it lays out a lot of those things. But also, if you're watching and you're not getting the mailings and the information, please feel free to call the office so we can get you registered. Sometimes things change, especially if people change a cell phone and we lose track of where to find people. So by all means, if you're not getting the mailings to our parish cluster, and you think you should be, we'd love to have you, but we need to get you registered with the parish. Please stand. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. The Mass is ended. Go in peace. Have a great day, everyone.